was born in Clinton. I was raised in Mount Carmel, Ontario. I did all my elementary school years at Our Lady of Mount Carmel. I moved to South Huron High School for grade 9 and 10. I went to Sir Frederick Banting for 11, 12. Then I moved to Calgary, where I started my university career. So pentathlon is a very historical sport. It was started from the cavalry days when the soldier needed to deliver a message. And so to be the perfect messenger, you had to know how to do all these things. You had to be able to swim your way across the river and fight, and you had to have a good shot, and you had to be able to run, and you had to be able to ride any horse that you were given. So that's where it all started. And then it evolved into the modern day Olympics, which was in 1912 is when they first started. Okay, the Pan Am Games is the second largest multi-sport games in the world to the Olympics. It's even bigger than the Winter Olympics. So it was my first major games, and it was actually really exciting. They have the whole athletes village, and you see Canadian athletes from all other sports, not just my own sport. So the Pan American Games was in Guadalajara, and in my sport, you have to be in the top four to qualify for the Olympic Games. And although I didn't get to bring a medal home for Canada, I was fourth, and I was ecstatic with that because I was able to book my ticket to the Olympics next year. So how the qualification works for pentathlon is that each continent will have their continental qualifiers. And so the North American continent uses the Pan Am Games as their qualifier. And so we only have four spots. Other continents with more participation will have more spots. Europe has eight. Oceania and Asia have six, and Africa has one spot. So all the continental spots have been filled. And in pentathlon, only 36 women and 36 men get to compete at the Olympics. So we have, I think, about 20 spots filled now, and the rest will be fought out over the world ranking list over the next season. So that's where I would have been bumped to if I didn't qualify at the Pan Am Games. And you want to be low so that you can be quick. And the next thing is you put your hand out. And you keep your hand up just like you're holding a baby bird. And you want to sit nice and straight with your head high so that you can read your opponent. Fencing is very much about reading your opponent.
One more time. Excellent. Good work. Excellent.
So, who wants to try the laser? All right. Put your arm there. And sit. How old are you? Okay, good. I want you to put both feet shoulder width apart like this. Come up to the red line right here. Okay, and then line it up with a circle down there. Oh! Oh, another one-hander. I'll say that when I was a little girl, I've had Olympic dreams since forever. Since my grandma will tell a story, actually. She always says, when I was like this big, I went up to her and said, Grandma, I'm going to go to the Olympics someday. But when I was that old, I was just a competitive swimmer and whatever else I was doing at school. So I wasn't any good. My younger sisters were beating me in the water. And so I soon realized that I'd have to find a new sport than swimming because it wasn't going to happen there. And then pentathlon came into my life. So I'm training full time for pentathlon right now, and I'm lucky enough to do so with the support of my parents and my coaches. A full day, I'll usually have 3 to 4 different training sessions. The first one starts at 6 a.m. in the water, and I swim every single day, except for Sundays. After that, I'll go straight to a combined practice with my coach. I'll have lunch, a little break, a massage, or physiotherapy if it's needed, which there is a lot of recovery involved in my sport. And then in the evening, I'll go to a track practice, and fencing is usually in the evening. Fencers like to fence from after dinner, so we'll fence in the evening, and every day we'll just kind of repeat like that, and twice a week, three times a week, I'll have a riding lesson in the middle of the day as well. The long-range dream has been to qualify for the Olympics, so now I can sit back and reevaluate. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do after the 2012 Olympics. I think I would definitely want to continue my career in athletics, whether it be pentathlon or whether I go off into just fencing or something like that, but I'm not really sure yet, actually. A small town, big dreams is definitely the motto to go with here, and you have to get out there and you have to look for it. It's not going to come knocking at your doorstep on that dirt road that you live on, so you need to get out of there. And for me, I moved around a lot in seeking this dream here. So you have to decide what's important, and you have to go after it, and you have to take risks, and you just have to know what you want and always have it up there. It sometimes it gets blurry and you can't see it, but you know, if you know what you want and you go after it, you'll get there.